about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Michigan is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. He's taken down at the 31-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He's tackled around the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, second down. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Finally, love to see the offensive coordinator finds a way to get the ball to the tight end. The quarterback has got to do a better job of communicating with the tight end to make sure they're both on the same page. Otherwise, they're going to continue to throw these incompletions.
So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
That makes it fourth and eight.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And down he goes at the 32. Michigan's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Strike to his receiver, no good. From their own 32-yard line. Second down. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle around the 37-yard line. So the defense does their job well on that series. And he's hammered down. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
You know, he's been working really hard lately on his fundamentals. In fact, the other day in practice, I was really watching him work with the quarterback coach, and they've been focusing on that aspect of it. Here, it looked like he may have taken a step backwards and really just let that one go.
He gets rid of this one. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Throws it out there, and that one's fallen incomplete.
Not a very impressive set of downs. The quarterback just doesn't seem to be throwing very confidently.
He really got a hold of that one. He got hit hard. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. And he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. Perfectly run option keeper.
Not what you'd expect when you prepare all week to defend the option. But then again, give this offense some credit. These guys aren't exactly the scout team.
First and 10 following that big run. Throws incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
He's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. It's on the ground. It's picked up by the defense. And he dives forward. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. And he hits him hard at the 26.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. The Broncos saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's knocked out of bounds at the 45.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
Their own 45-yard line. First down. Runs it right. Nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Pitch, and now he's got the corner. The ball is loose. The defense has it. He makes his way to about the 38.
I tell you, when the option works, it can be beautiful to watch. But when it doesn't, it can go horribly wrong. Not a good result for the offense.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
That makes it second and 6.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Throws it out right to the running back. Steps out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Brought down at about the 35.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And this one goes out of the end zone, so they'll bring it out to the 20.
Boy, this is just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Well, it's a combination of a couple things, Brad. I think the defenses are playing well, but I think the offenses at this point are making it a little bit easier for them. So let's see if these offenses can get it going a little bit to try to challenge these defenses.
Now he's scrambling, and they get the sack.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. It seems like they almost saved their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
Might have been some early movement up front.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
Second down and a ways to go because of the penalty. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Oh, so close to breaking it. So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. We played one quarter. No score here. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. From the 48-yard line, it's second down. And down he goes, right around the 38-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. Here's a handoff, and he's brought down right away. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Takes the ball inside. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line.
Big play, and on fourth down to boot. The entire offense looked in sync on that play.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Roger. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Tackle made right around the 14-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From the 14-yard line, first down. He laterals. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Zips it to the back. He's taken down right around the 2-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense.
And he has it on the corner. Touchdown, Wolverines. And he adds the extra point. An 11-play, 85-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drop. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Strike complete, and he's down. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. Third down.
Run, and he's brought down. That's good enough to pick up the first down.
Solid 5-yard pickup. He was almost able to get to the secondary, but as it is, he still manages to move the sticks.
Big opening. And they make the stop at the 49. Boise State's going to use their first time out of the half here. About 2 minutes before halftime. Gobbled up in the backfield.
Call a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll make it third and one.
He's tackled around the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, it's first down. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. Tackle around the 11-yard line. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
He makes it to the 9.
That's a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 7 and 8.
Ball inside the 10-yard line. Second down. Here comes the pressure. Breaks one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
10th play of the drive. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. This one should be makeable. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Boise State is ready to kick it away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Michigan holds a 4-point lead. Scrambling around. And he's tackled right around the 24-yard line. He got 3 yards there on the scramble.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on their own 24. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Complete and taken down immediately. A great first half comes to a close. Michigan's up by four. We welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Go down, go down. Watch 19, watch 19.
They get nice yardage on that run. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Michigan is up by four. He's to the 40. That's a great tackle at the 44-yard line. The corner. He might have a chance. And he tackles him hard at the 37.
19 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 37-yard line, first down. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He scrambles, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Decides to slide. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Michigan is up four. Brought down around the 4 yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. They run left, and he'll lose yardage. This is a big play for the offense that can put them up by two scores. It's third down from the four. Fires quickly to the tight end.
They go to the air and pick up a couple.
Usually you get a linebacker covering the tight end, so they might want to try some longer passes to exploit that mismatch.
It's up, and they tack on 3 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Tackle made at the 22. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Has some daylight.
He makes his way to about the 42. From their own 42-yard line, first down. At about the 43-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Looks to him again, complete. Very good tackle in space. From the 24-yard line, it's first down. He has all day, but scrambles out. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Gets it out quickly, and he's taken down at about the 13. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 13. It out to about the 11-yard line.
That's good for the 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Defense wins championships, baby. Hey, alert 48. Hey, go back to 48. Let's go.
He gets out to about the 9-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive.
I got him. Hey, look, 48. Hey, go back to 48.
He's got it. Touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
Will be tied with the extra point. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Play action. He throws. And that one's fallen incomplete.
Good effort there by the receiver, but just not enough room for him to get a foot down in bounds.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's sacked.
So at the end of three, this one's all even at 10. Who's going to win the fourth quarter? Whoever does will win the ball game. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He tackles him for a loss. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. Intercepted. What a crucial interception, and that'll change the whole landscape of this game.
And now is the time to take advantage. This offense still has a job to do. They need to put points on the board to break this tie. But wow, do we have a great game or what?
And he hits him hard at the 36. It's second and 12. Ball on the 36-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That makes it 37.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. Tackle made at the 47. That screen pass nets maybe 5 yards. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's taken down at about the 31. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 31. They'll bring him down at the 50. Less than 3 minutes in the game. From the 46-yard line, it's second down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Gets it out to the wideout, and he's got the first. And they make the stop at the 32.
zips it to the back. He's tackled at about the 21.
From the 21-yard line, first down.
It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds. Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A seven-play, 79-yard drive. They add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a seven-on-seven drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
The score now, 17-10. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Wolverines have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now you just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. Oh, and a huge drop by the wideout here in the fourth quarter. He goes out of bounds at the 40. A gain of one.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
They really need to pick up this third and long here in the fourth quarter. Here's the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled at the 44. Just under two to go in the game.
If you kill it, motion me out.
Complete. He's got room. He's out of bounds at the 34-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on 34. He's going to try and scramble. And he's level at the 30-yard line. Fires it out. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. The Wolverines will use their first time out of the half. Well, this is it. They've got all four downs to get in the end zone. Quick throw, tackle at the 7. Michigan's going to have to use their second time out of the half. This is the 9th play of this drive.
Yeah. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. Goes to the end zone. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
This is it. They've got to get it in the end zone.
Quick strike and it's caught for the touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT.
Late in the fourth quarter, and with that score, we are now tied. And the way things are going, we might be going to an extra session or two.
Michigan lines up for the kickoff. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Late in the fourth quarter now, game is tied. Which coach can out-coach the other? It's a chess match right now. Under a minute left.
Quick strike to the receiver. That's a great tackle at the 38-yard line. One will fall incomplete.
Boy, this is a great play by the safety to be able to be in a position to make this play, but he's got to be able to hold on to the football. You know, he's a big, physical, athletic guy, but you've got to be able to secure a football and make a big play when it presents itself.
Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. Brought down around the 47-yard line.
It was time for somebody to step up and make a play, and boy, did the defense come through. Now they've got a chance to take the lead. That was huge.
First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. Short over the middle, and down he goes, right around the 40. He's on the run.
Just a tremendous play there late in the fourth quarter in a tie football game. And now it all comes down to the final seconds or overtime. Back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 7-6.
From the 21-yard line, it's second down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's taken down at the 17-yard line. And the kicker comes out to try to put 3 points on the board here in overtime. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights.
Thank you. quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Fires out to his wideout. What a play to set him up for the first and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Tackle made around the 3 yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
And he is drilled at the 2 yard line. Big third and goal. Can the defense stop him?
Tremendous effort to take advantage of the defense holding them to a field goal. They knew they were going to have a chance to win this, and they came through. Just a fantastic finish.
And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, Boise State 23, Michigan 20. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.